गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ योर जियोग्राफी लेसन. स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट 9 इंडस्ट्रियल डिवेलपमेंट सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शियरी इंडस्ट्रीज. एंड यस्टरडे वी रेड अबाउट प्रिंसिपल फैक्ट्री इंडस्ट्रीज इन पाकिस्तान. फर्स्ट cotton textile industry. I hope you have understood a lot about cotton textile industry. In today's lesson, we will discuss about the sugar industry as well as the fertilizer industry. So we start our lesson. The sugar industry in Pakistan is the second largest agro-based industry. The sugar industry in Pakistan is the second largest agro-based industry. Pakistan is an important cane producing country and is ranked 5th in world cane acreage and 15th in sugar production. Its share in value added of agriculture and GDP are 3.4% and 0.7% respectively. The sugar sector constitutes 4.2% of manufacturing. What is the percentage of manufacturing? 4.2%. The sugar industry employs over 1.5 million people. How many people are involved in this industry? 1.5 million people, including management experts, technologists, engineers, financial experts, skilled, semi-skilled and unskilled workers. So a huge number of people are involved in this industry. I need you to open page number 159 and read more about sugar industry. The sugar industry is one of the vital industries, as this is very important industry in the economic development of Pakistan. Sugar is mainly made from sugar cane. We get sugar from sugar cane. Sugar mills are located in Punjab, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and Sindh. So most of the sugar mills are developed or established in Punjab, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and Sindh. There are three provinces where sugar mills are established. Balochistan does not have any sugar mills. Sugar mills have to be located near the sugar cane fields because sugar cane starts losing its sugar content as soon as it is harvested. It needs to be crushed immediately. As we get the crop of sugar cane, we have to crush it immediately because it is a fear that it lose its fertility. Sugarcane is bulky and heavy, and so it is expensive to transport. We cannot transport it easily because of the heavy weight. Byproducts of the sugar industry and their uses. What are byproducts? Byproduct of sugar cane. Byproducts of the sugar industry and their uses. Bagasse. Bagasse can be used as fuel in sugar mills. used to make chipboard, paper and animal feed. So it is produced in the mill house in a quantity of about 30% of the crushed cane. The bagasse contains 50% moisture. It is used as a fuel for boiler. Fuel for boilers processing stage. In a processing stage, bagasse is also used for chipboard and paper manufacture, as I have already told you. Molasses used to manufacture various types of acids in the chemical industry. So molasses is a common ingredient in baking, often used in baked goods such as gingerbread and gingerbread cookies. Fertilizer industry. The fertilizer industry is made up of companies that represent the entire supply chain from production to distribution to retail, all working together to deliver fertilizer to farmers in a safe, timely and sustainable manner. What is the fertilizer industry? The fertilizer industry is made up of companies that represent the entire supply chain from production to distribution to retail, all working together to deliver fertilizer to farmers in a safe, timely and sustainable manner. Fertilizer industry. Chemical fertilizers have considerably increased since the Green Revolution in the 1960s. Students, the Green Revolution in Pakistan was introduced in 1960s, and the introduction of high yield varieties in Pakistan's agriculture along with the better chemical fertilizers and tube well irrigation has impacted the agriculture production in Pakistan to the great extent. In Pakistan, the Green Revolution was first introduced in its Punjab province. And with regard to wheat production, Punjab experienced the increase of yield in wheat by 2.3% during the period from 1972 to 1987 due to the introduction of new wheat varieties. So this is Green Revolution. Fertilizers are very important for increasing agricultural production, as we see that different fertilizers are used for by the farmers to enhance the production of their crops. And different advertisements can be seen on television, internet and other social media that convince the farmers and agriculturists to use these fertilizer to promote and to grow more crops in the fields. Various raw materials, e.g. sulfur, phosphate, gypsum are used to make different types of fertilizers. After its discovery in Pakistan, natural gas became the main raw material. Faisalabad and Daud Khail in Punjab, Haripur in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and Darki in Upper Sindh are the main locations. So students, if you have visited the province of Sindh, you can see there is Angro Fertilizers, 4G fertilizer company, and we can see other fertilizers as National Fertilizer Corporation. These are the examples of fertilizer corporation in Pakistan. And these chemicals are used for nutrition for plants. Nitrogenous fertilizer is most commonly used, 92% of the total production, because the soils are deficient in organic matter. So this is the most important fertilizer used for the growth of crops and enrich the soil as well. After 1977, a number of fertilizer projects were completed. The Pak Arab Fertilizer Factory at Multan started production in 1979. So, students, Pak Arab Fertilizers Private Limited is located at Hanewal Road, Multan. It is the largest fertilizer complex in Pakistan and the only factory producing calcium ammonium nitrate, nitrophosphate, and this is raw material for manufacture of fertilizers. So students, this is enough for today. I hope you are clear about these two industries. You have to learn key facts about these industries. Thank you for listening. Take care. Allah Hafiz.